boys and girls, and welcome back to Friendship Kids. I'm so excited to continue with our big redemptive story this week as we continue with the life of David. If you remember, at the end of last week's lesson, I told you that this week is a sad lesson because we're going to see that David does a terrible sin in the eyes of God. David's life up to this point has been filled with success, with God's favor, and the people really love David. But we're going to find it all comes crashing down when we see what David does this week. Now, what's important about this week is we're going to see the seriousness of sin, but we're also going to see the mercy of our good God. So there's lots to learn in today's lesson. But before we begin, let's start with a word of prayer. So go ahead, close your eyes, and let's pray together. God, we thank you so much for the Bible. We thank you for the truths that we find in your word. Thank you so much for sharing who you are with us and showing us how you're merciful and good God. God, I pray as we look into today's lesson that you'll keep us from sin. You'll keep our hearts from forgetting you and for going our own way. Protect us. Give us clean hearts. Give us hearts that love you more than sin. And I pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, guys, let's take a look at our big picture question. And then we'll recap a little bit about what we've been learning, and then we'll jump into today's lesson. So let's take a look at the big picture question. Well, boys and girls, we're actually going to keep the same big picture question for a couple more weeks. We've seen the sin of Saul. We're going to see the sin of David. So it is so important to realize that Jesus, unlike those men, is absolutely perfect. Jesus is the perfect king. And how is he the perfect king? Well, we've been learning it. Jesus perfectly rules over the universe as the King of Kings. Jesus never has sinned. He is absolutely perfect. And he, even today, rules over the entire universe as the King of Kings. No one is more powerful. No one is stronger. No one has his wisdom. He is perfect. And he rules over everything. He is the perfect king. Well, let's take a look at what we've been learning about a not perfect king, David, over the last several weeks. We saw that Saul sinned against God, and so God chose David to be king instead of Saul. Do you think that made Saul happy? Absolutely not. So Saul hated David. But David had a golden opportunity to kill Saul and never have to worry about Saul killing him. But what did we learn that David did? Well, we saw that David showed mercy, even though Saul hated him. David spared Saul's life and was a perfect example of the mercy of God. Well, the story continued, and we saw that God made a special promise with David. God made a covenant, and he said that the Messiah would come from David's family. The one who would deliver people from their sins. He was going to be born into David's family. What an awesome blessing. David was super privileged and super humbled to be a recipient of such a great gift. Well, the story continued, and we saw that because David was a recipient of God's grace, he was able to show that same grace to other people. We saw last week that David showed kindness to Jonathan's son, Mephibosheth. Jonathan's son was Saul's grandson. And though David could have been mean to his enemy Saul, again, David showed kindness. But boys and girls, David did not always do the right thing. In today's lesson, we are going to see that David sinned against God. He did a horrible thing. Well, boys and girls, before we watch this week's video, I want you to understand where we are at in the story of the Israelites. There were enemies called the Ammonites, and they hated the Israelites. But David, he wanted to show kindness to the Ammonites. But every time he wanted to show kindness, the Ammonites rejected Israel's recipients. They mocked them and they humiliated them. They did this over and over to the point that it began a war between the Ammonites and the Israelites. But the good news is God was on the Israelites' side. David had experienced a time of blessing from God and success in war. The tribes of Israel were all united under David and they loved him. Everything in David's life seemed to be going perfectly. He was successful. He had God's favor over the nation of Israel. But that success and that favor did not last much longer. So let's watch this week's lesson and learn of David's sin and how he repented and was restored by God.
David was the king of Israel. One spring, David sent out the army, but he put another man in charge of them. David stayed in Jerusalem. One evening, David looked out from his palace and saw a beautiful woman named Bathsheba. Bathsheba was the wife of Uriah, one of the best warriors in David's army. David sent his messengers to get Bathsheba, and she came to David's house. Later, Bathsheba told David that she was going to have a baby. The baby would be David's.
David knew what he had done was wrong. David should not have a baby with someone who is not his wife. So David made a plan to make sure no one found out that Bathsheba's baby was his. David called Uriah home from the battle and told him to go spend time with his wife. But Uriah didn't think it was fair for him to relax at home while the other men were at war. He slept on David's doorstep and refused to visit his wife. So David made up another plan.
He instructed Joab, the leader of the army, to send Uriah into the hardest part of the battle so he would be killed. This time, David's plan worked. Uriah was killed in battle. David took Bathsheba into his house to be his wife, and she had a baby boy. God knew what David had done, and he was not happy with David. God sent Nathan the prophet to talk to David. Nathan told David a story. A traveler came to a rich man who had many animals. The rich man, to not offer his own animal, instead, he took a poor man's lamb, the only lamb he had, and gave it to the traveler to eat. This story made David feel angry. The rich man should die, David said. You are the man, Nathan said.
God had given David a position of great power, and David took what wasn't his. David realized he had sinned against God. David deserved to die. You won't die for this, Nathan assured David, but God will punish you. Your son will die instead.
David confessed his sin and prayed, God, create a clean heart for me. David realized he could try to please God with sacrifices, but that wouldn't be enough to pay for his sin. God wanted David's heart to change so that he would not want to sin again.
When David sinned against God, God forgave him, but sin always comes with a price. God spared David's life, but David's son died. When we sin, we deserve death, but we can receive God's forgiveness because God sent his son, Jesus, to pay the price for our sin.
What a sad time in the life of David. David knew that it was wrong to take another man's wife, but he did it anyways, and God punished him for it. Boys and girls, God takes sin and disobedience very seriously. God is perfect. He is holy. He always does what is right. His nature is good. And we as people, we are sinners and we often do our own thing and get ourselves into a complete mess as we disobey the good order of our God. And David did exactly that. One sin led to another, and he ended up having another man killed to try to cover up his sin. And that just perfectly shows what sin does in our lives. Sin deceives us, and we often try to cover up our mess so that we don't get in trouble. But God wants something far more important to happen than just for us to get out of trouble. He wants us to have a new nature. He wants us to be new creatures with new hearts so that we don't desire sin and we desire to have a heart just like him. Well, as believers in Jesus, there are times where we do still sin against God. But we saw in the story that David, eventually, he did repent of his sin and ask God to forgive him. And here's the best news of all. Though David really blew it, he did something horrible. I mean, he had a man killed. He stole another man's wife. That was a horrible, horrible thing. But you know what, boys and girls? David repented. He was broken over his sin. And you know what? God forgave him. God restored him. Even though there were consequences for his sin, God allowed a way through Jesus for David to be restored and to have a right relationship with him again. And that goes perfectly with this week's memory verse. For us today, that though we sin, God promises that we can confess that sin and he will forgive us. Let's look at this week's memory verse from 1 John 1:9. This week's verse is one of the most precious promises in all of the Bible. It says, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Boys and girls, all of us are sinners, and every day we sin against our God. But this promise from God's word is incredible. It says, if we confess those sins, God is faithful, and he is just to forgive us of our sins, and he will cleanse us from all unrighteousness. When we confess our sins to God and agree with him that we have made mistakes, that we've done what we should not do, God does a wonderful thing in forgiving us. But not just forgiving us, he cleanses us. And he continues to create in us a new heart so that we'll love him far more than our sin and we won't desire to do those same sins again. What a precious promise. And I hope each and every one of us are taking advantage of it every time that we sin. Boys and girls, God gave us that verse because he knows that we are going to sin. Matter of fact, every Bible character that we've looked at so far this year, they were sinners. Everybody has sinned. That's exactly what the Bible tells us. And sin deserves death. It deserves punishment. Just like this week's lesson taught us, David deserved to die because of his sin. And you know what? I deserve to die because of my sin. I deserve to be separated from God because of the sins that I have committed. And the Bible tells us that the same is true for you. When we disobey God, we deserve to be separated from God. But the good news is that we don't have to be separated from God because someone came to take the death that we deserve. Someone came to take our punishment for us. Who is that? Well, I hope you guys know it by now. That person was God himself. He sent his son, Jesus, to take our punishment and to take the death we deserve. We do a terrible thing by disobeying God, but God in his love makes a way so that we don't have to be punished for it. Incredible. David needed a savior. I need a savior. You need a savior. I want us to sing a song together as we all confess together that we need a savior. Let's sing this song together. I hope you remember it. It's called I Need a Savior.
Sheep have gone astray. We have chosen our own way. In humility I pray. I need a Savior. Grace to cover every sin. Righteousness and peace within. Life eternal, hope again. I need a Savior.
All right, let's see what you remember from this week's lesson and this week's Bible story trivia. Our first question is really familiar to you by now. It is worth 5 points. How is Jesus the perfect king? Can you remember the answer to our big picture question? I hope you're getting it by now. Jesus perfectly rules over the universe as the King of Kings. Those are lots of words, but I hope that you are getting the message to that answer. All right, question number two. This one is worth 4 points. From the story, what was the name of the woman who David saw from his rooftop? This is Uriah's wife, the wife that David wanted for himself. You remember her name? Well, the answer is Bathsheba. Her name was Bathsheba. Kind of a funny name. All right, question number three. And this one is worth 8 points. What did David do to Bathsheba's husband? If you remember from the story, David wanted Bathsheba to be his wife, but she was already married. So what did David do to her husband? Well, David was in control of the army and he told them to put Uriah, Bathsheba's husband, at the front of the army when they went to battle. There was no way that Uriah was going to survive that. David knew exactly what he was doing. David had Bathsheba's husband killed. Another horrible sin in this week's lesson. All right, question number four, and this one's worth 6 points. How did David feel when he heard the story of the rich man taking the poor man's land? If you remember, the prophet Nathan told David a story about a rich man who had a bunch of sheep taking a poor man's sheep when it was the only one that he had. It was a pretty sad story, and David felt a specific way after he heard it. Do you remember what he felt? Well, the story told us that David was angry, and rightfully so. But David didn't realize that he was the rich man that Nathan was describing. All right, question number five, our last question, worth 7 points. What did God do when David confessed his sin? This goes perfectly with our verse that told us when we confess our sins, God does something. And God did exactly that when David confessed his sin. Do you remember what God did and how he responded? Well, the verse told us, if we confess our sins, God is faithful and just to forgive us our sins. God forgave David when David confessed his sin. That's an important lesson for us to remember, not just for a trivia question, but for our everyday life. Well, boys and girls, we've learned a lot in today's lesson. We've seen that God takes sin very seriously. We've also seen that everybody sins, even King David. King David needed the same gospel that you and I need today. Jesus lived a perfect life and died on the cross in exchange for our sinfulness. We give him our sin, and he gives us his perfect life. Only because of Jesus and what he did on the cross can we stand before God and not have to die. Jesus took our death, and we now can have a relationship with God as his children. When David sinned, he needed that mercy of Jesus. And boys and girls, every day when we sin, we need that same mercy. Let us never forget about Jesus, and let us never feel confident in our own obedience that we can stand before God. It's all about our relationship with Jesus. Though this week was kind of sad as we saw David's disobedience, it was really good to see that God never gives up on sinners. No matter what you've done, no matter what sin you've committed, there is grace and mercy enough to forgive. So remember that each and every time that you sin. Our God is a gracious God, and he wants us to come to him confessing our sin. He loves, he delights to show mercy. Well, David received the mercy of God, and he was a changed man because of it. I can't wait to see next week as we learn about some of the Psalms that David wrote as praise and as a prayer to God. So come back next week and we'll look a little closer at those Psalms. All right, guys. Well, it's been another great lesson. I hope you guys are having a great summer, and I hope to see you very soon. We love you guys. We miss you guys. But tune in next week as we continue our big redemptive story here at Friendship Kids. See you next week.